I made a commitment to myself when I was about 17, 18 that I was going to squeeze every drop out of life. I was 47 when I was diagnosed with stage 4 lung cancer. I'm just determined to carry on, squeezing every drop out. If it's 5 years, if it's 10 years, if it's 2 years, I just think life's out there to grab and enjoy every minute, really. Diagnosis was January 2015. I had a couple of minor episodes of pins and needles in my left hand. On this one particular day, I actually felt some weakness and I found I couldn't smile straight. I went to local accident and emergency. The consultant came around and confirmed that it did appear that I was presented with a TIA, or even the beginnings of a full-blown stroke. They just wanted to do a check scan, MRI of my head. I was lying on the scanner, obviously couldn't hear what was being said, but there were very serious looking faces. Clearly, this was not just a routine scan. They'd obviously found something. The doctor then told me that they'd seen this on the scan and it looked likely that it was cancer. I just felt my world shift on its axis. The primary was seen on chest x-ray and it was stage 4 lung cancer. This was just way off what I ever thought I would be diagnosed with. I was a non-smoker and, you know, I should have known really that if you've got lungs, you're at risk of lung cancer. I had a biopsy and I wanted those results quick because I knew that was going to guide the treatment choice. So I had a 2 week wait. Life sparkles to me and I just couldn't see any sparkle. Everything just went black. I felt desperate. I couldn't see a way out and it didn't want to feel like that. It didn't feel like me. It was quite bittersweet, really. It was lovely to be here, but it was just like, I'm not ready to leave all of this yet. My husband and I did sit down and we did have a serious conversation about the quality, quantity of life, considering the amount of quality time that traditional chemotherapy treatment approach would have given me. Actually, would I even go down that route because of the impact on my health, even in whatever time I had left? I truly believed it was just going to be a miserable trajectory to an early grave. My genetic testing results had come through. The doctor sat me down and it was confirmed that I was EGFR and it was an exon 19 deletion. And his phrase at the time was, "This is your silver lining." That meant the world to me. It was the only glimmer of positive news I'd had in 2 weeks of sheer hell. He then started talking about the targeted therapies. It was definitely was something that he felt was appropriate as a first-line treatment. And the results have obviously borne that out. People look at me and forget it's there. When they first heard, they were expecting me to look a completely different person, you know, very, very thin, ill and frail. And then they see someone leap out the front door in high-vis lycra, go, let's go for a run then. Cancer potentially disenfranchises every part of your life. People with every well-meaning intention will come in and try and do things for you. And I think it turns people into patients. And that's what I've clung on to. I am the same person. I'm now the same person as you met 5 years ago. I just now am walking around with cancer. It is important to me to continue to be me. That's what targeted therapy has done for me. I live my life as I did before. I make choices and I make plans in the way that I did before. It's given me my life back. that promise I made to myself when I was a teenager, I'm remaking it. Because nobody knows how long we're going to be here, but I've just had that. It really might not be as long as you think, so don't waste a minute.